Well, hello, and welcome back. So I opened up the top of the next box, and it's filled with all these air saver cushions, and at first I was going to be very sad that it wasn't something I could pop. Then I realized I could pop them, but then I read them. They have all these contact numbers on them, but they're made from recycled plastic, and they donate a portion of the proceeds to support environmental and social charities. So rather than actually blowing these up and popping them, despite how satisfying that would be, I'm going to reuse them. I'm going to reduce, reuse, and recycle. As per the request on the bag. 10 points for you, air saver.
Oh, I don't know how it saves air. I swear it takes more air to fill these than it does a little bit of... But that's semantics.
So remember before, in the last box, we opened up some of these holders, some of these stands for large crystal balls. Well, unsurprisingly, I'm going to open up a large crystal ball. Let's see. Now, I can say that it's 110 millimeters. I can say that it is 11 centimeters. That doesn't really do it justice, I find. Ooh, that's horrible. It's like fingers on a chalkboard. Spat it out! However, when you get to... Oh, gosh. That's heavy. There. When you get to see a 110 millimeter crystal ball, it's a lot more impressive and very heavy. Very, very heavy. But those go on those stands. I have to admit, I'm too lazy to go grab one. It's getting pretty late at night, so I'm just going to put them to the side. And yeah, the big book is there still, mostly because I have no idea where I'm going to put it. And there's the second of the giant crystal balls of doom. Now this makes absolutely no sound. So let's see what's inside. Well, that's why it makes no sound. I had somebody in earlier today asking me about tarot card boxes. And this box should fit most sets. Oh, it's made out of mango wood. Mango wood is a wood that you're always going to know when you touch it. And it's covered in knotwork, and then there's a pentacle on the top with knotwork around it. Very pretty. Although I'd love to linger more, I've really got to
keep removing. Gonna run out of energy.
And this one feels lighter. I wonder if this is another box, or if this is a super extra bonus surprise something. It's filled with paper! Yay! Oh. Or a box. It's another box.
Oh, awesome.
So I have a bunch of heathen friends, and I have been trying to find stuff that will make your spirit soar. Oh, that's pretty. I don't know what kind of wood this is. A very beautiful yellow cast to it, but it's covered in a knotwork on top, and I can't remember the name of that symbol. I'm sorry to all my heathen friends. I'm so sorry. I forgot the name of it. But it is a symbol of Odinism. Correct me if I'm wrong. Actually, in the comments below, if I was right, give me a thumbs up. If I was wrong, correct me. I love new information. Whenever you're proven wrong, it just means you have better information, so it's something to celebrate. Unless, of course, you really like being wrong, in which case, hold on to the thing you were proven wrong in. It's not a good decision in my mind. Ooh, it's delightful. Oh. Some of the things I ordered were these tiny, cutesy little chests, and I wonder if this is one of them.
I think it is. Oh, it is so!
Okay, well, the pictures really didn't do these justice. Beautiful little bone jewelry chest. Oh, the purple lining. Very pretty. Not to everybody's taste. Say, if you despise the color purple, this would not be up your alley. However, very pretty otherwise. I bet you that means this is probably similar. I only ordered, I think, one of each of the designs that they made. Oh, that could end.
Yeah.
Isn't that funny? The other one, the top opened. This one, the side opens. Yeah. Same kind of thing, this time with a triquetra. If you're like, what the heck's a triquetra, and you're just joining us, I had a cauldron earlier on tonight that had the triquetra on it. And I'll be able to show you. This is a triquetra. Same kind of thing. Looks like the same purple inside. Yep, same purple inside. Very pretty. Lovely stuff. Okay. On to the next one. Ooh. Oh, cool. So for trinkets and jewelry and stuff like this, I found these boxes that have all this brass work on them. They're really cute, actually. Are they all different? No. So I got two of that variety. And they're just little. Good for starting spells or who knows what. Got some jewelry or something in there. It's a very pretty way to keep some trinkets. One of the great things that really attracted me to them too is that they were incredibly affordable. So these will be a good price, I imagine. I'll have to figure it all out. I need to go through the invoice yet. Where do I go? This one. You know, given how the last one felt, the first one I did rather, I bet you this is another wooden box. Sure is. Again, about the size of a set of tarot cards. Kind of standard. And one thing to keep in mind, too, is that oracle decks and tarot decks, they can vary greatly in size. So if you're looking for one, either for yourself or as a gift, what you could do is take your card, trace it, the outline of it on a piece of paper, bring that piece of paper in, it folds up nice and easy in your pocket, and if you can lay the piece of paper down flat inside the box, you're good to go. This one, speaking of triquetras earlier, is another triquetra with flowers, hand carved. Very pretty. Next. Another box. Oh. You are prettier in person. You'll see what I mean in a second. Let me just get this out of here. So this one is called the Triple Moon Box. And it's absolutely surrounded with pentacles. It's got some kind of a really neat green gold tin. The top of it has the Maiden Mother Crone symbol, the star in it. Let's see what the inside looks like. Black velvet. Very cool. Oh, that's pretty. You know, I thought that was pretty when I saw it in the picture, and yeah, every once in a while, some of these things are just stunning. And the picture does not do it justice. Like that letter holder. The letter holder looked like it was about that tall when I saw it in the picture. No, it's huge. Ooh, you're bigger. What are you? Let's find out. Try not to cut myself. If my scoutmaster is watching, I was paying attention. I cut away from myself now. Now. Oh, I think I know what this is. I got some little herb cabinets. These people were asking me if I had any kind of cabinetry or anything like that for herbs. And I didn't. Oh, this one is the chakra one with the Om on top. Yes, it is so. Got bones on the side. And if you have animals or children you need to keep out of your herbs, it has a little swinging lock on both sides. That way it secures so you don't have to worry about anybody eating the wormwood. Cool. It's got a whole bunch of little shells in here. Oh, that's neat.
Lock that back up.
And onward. Onward and upward. What are you? Are you more of the similar? Let's find out. Oh, I think this is another cabinet. Oh, that's pretty.
So that's what it looks like from the front. Pentacles on the side.
Oh, you need to see the top.
The top's slightly angled because it opens to reveal one storage area. There is a drawer.
There. I'm sorry, I have no fingernails. I just have phalange nubs. Don't chew your nails, is what I wish more people would say to me when I was young. Now, the bottom component, or compartment rather, that one has a lock, and I imagine that's where you could keep dangerous herbs.
There. Very pretty.
And just the right size to sit on an altar without taking up your entire house worth of space. This is one I've been waiting to meet. Oh, ever since I saw the picture, I couldn't wait to meet this one. This is called the Salem Witch's Box.
Still a bit of packing stuff on it. A little bit of fuzz. But it's got aged and distressed metal on it.
Sometimes things seemed a lot smaller in the picture or seemed a lot bigger in the picture. This is one of the cases of, I swore this was going to be a heck of a lot smaller. This is really kind of, oh, and it's mangoing. It's a Tree of Life tarot box, so I expected it to be more about the size of a normal tarot card box. As you can see, it is substantially larger. Enormous. Oh, that's pretty. It's a lovely Tree of Life on that one. Gorgeous. Oh, that's gorgeous. This box actually is probably going to be relatively quick. There's only four more boxes in here. Let's see what this one is. Oh, this is one of the chests. It's covered in paper. Oh, that's brutal. So it has some metal additions all over the outside of it. Some studs, very, very pretty. It has a triple moon goddess on both sides and a pentacle on the top. Let's take a look inside. Wow, that's pretty spacious. One of the things I like is the antiqued and distressed hinges. I think that's pretty damn cool. It makes it look like an antique piece. Oh, wow! Like a proper chest, actually. I don't know if you can see this. The top of it is made out of little slats of wood. They look pretty uniform from the outside, but from the inside, it's apparent that they're not. You can buy a little lock, lock that up, and keep some secret treasures in there. Well, this makes me more excited to see what else is in here. one's another one of the chests.
Let me in.
And yeah, there's a giant pile of paper and cardboard and plastic forming on the left. But, well, my left, you're right. But that's okay, I'll clean it up tomorrow morning. This one is kind of nice and plain. Not as tall as the other one, but it's got a nice metal edging that has a neat texture to it. And it's got three pentacles on the top. Another lock. Well, the hinges on this one aren't distressed, but the top is made in the exact same manner, a proper chest top. Very pretty. Oh, that's cool. Actually, what we're going to do, we're going to get this big box out of the way. Empty. Now, it bears mentioning that there are still two other boxes, actually technically three other boxes in the shipment. One of them is a whole bunch of my medium-sized rock salt lamps, again from the Free Tibet Foundation. Awesome stuff. Now, are you there? I was worried it was stapled all the way around. I was going to say, oh, this one was packaged by a sadist. This is another herb cabinet. This one with the Tree of Life symbol on it. Very, very similar to the other one in design. That is to say, pull it out so you can see it. It is to say that it's got the top that opens for that little cabinet. The drawer. Now this one, it bears mentioning, the Tree of Life one does not have a lock on it. So if you've got young ones or pets, it might be good to put this out of the way where they can't reach it. But another little herb cabinet. You know, technically they're called herb cabinets, but I don't know about you. I have too many herbs to be able to put in one of these. Although I can think of about 10,000 other uses for them. I think this one's mango too. Feels good. Let's put that there. Oh, there it is. I was worried I lost my knife. I can't do this job without my toys. Oh. Another chest. This one doesn't have any extremely sacred artwork on it per se. Is covered in swirls. Swirls and spirals, and it looks like a tree. I don't know if you can see that. It does not have the big old latch on it, but it is beautiful. It's a pretty, pretty chest. Well, that was box number two. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you had a good time going through that box with me. I know I had a really good time going through that box. Holy smokes. A lot of really pretty stuff, some great gift ideas for the season coming up. Gosh, I can't put everything down here. I just kind of wanted to give you another final look at it. It's some of the stuff that we unboxed in this box. I hope you had a good time. I hope I entertained you, didn't get too boring. I'm going to open up the rest of these tomorrow night, so when you next see me, I'm going to be wearing different clothing. In the meantime, have yourselves a fantastic night, and we'll see you at the PMC.